I thought I paused it. Just noticed that it was off.
This is it.
Dipshit. No, dip. I'm dead. I got killed. Oh dang, I tried saving that dude. I'm pretty sure he gets hanged after he gets his arm cut off. I wanna see that, but I guess not. Cause the law decided to interfere. It's kinda dumb. I don't think they should be able to interfere with your stuff unless it's part of the mission or part of helping a person, because yeah, I just don't really think so. Plus, he's a murderer anyways. So, I'm still gonna do it because it would bring my one thing higher, but eh. Wait a second. Yeah. Well, horse as a boy, he sure has no balls, meaning he's not brave. Literally. Not brave at all. Oh my gosh, that freaking scared the freaking crap out of me. Dude, they're literally just spawning by my feet, except the ones that I can see. This way? No, 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 that's not what I said. This way. And no, 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 that's not what I said, horse. Okay, fine. I'll do it. Oh my gosh.
Morning, friend. Of course, of course. Oh, and here is my dear friend, Archer Callahan. Boy is a hunter. Boy is a killer. Arthur, you've met but not been introduced to Mr. Oh, I'm so sorry. Sheriff.
Well, how are you doing, sir?
I'm fine.
Tough business you boys had.
We did?
Well, there's no need to pretend with me, sir. Life can be tough.
So it can.
And no man owes another anything.
No, sir.
But still, I feel you were hard done by. Losing your employment like that. But still, here in Rhodes, we have work enough for honest men.
That's some strong stuff. Still, don't seem to be doing you any harm, I guess.
Exactly. Ooh. Excuse me a moment.
I told you we was moving up in this world. Deputies.
You have finally lost your mind.
Amongst these drunkards, hillbillies, and slavers? Good honest thieves like us. We're bound to be moralizers in a place like this.
Oh! Sheriff Gray, you are back.
Now listen, sir. There is shine in them woods, though. And it is costing this county its good name. And the state a whole lot of income. You boys wouldn't mind rooting it out. Maybe we'll make you permanent. I gotta set me down.
Not a problem, sir. Not a problem at all. You are in safe hands now.
And people waste time, temperance movement. Liquor never dulled a good man's senses. Arthur, you ride with the deputy. Bill and I will follow.
Climb on up. Let's go.
Archibald.
you.
Pretty good.
And your friend is behaving himself?
Oh, yes. I think he's learned his lesson.
Congratulations on becoming a temporarily deputized citizen of Scarlet Meadows County. Most towns just get bounty hunters to do their dirty work these days, but Sheriff Gray believes the law should keep the law. Now, I'm sure I don't need to remind you, there's a chain of command here.
There is?
Dang straight there is. This is a dangerous business, but follow my lead and you'll be just fine.
Sure. Hey! Archibald wants to remind us he's in charge here.
Of course.
Who else would be?
You were a big help with them Anderson boys, and I put in a very good word with the sheriff on your behalf.
We appreciate that.
We rounded up the others soon after. I'm pushing for the rope myself, but that's by the by.
So, these moonshiners?
Not just any moonshiners. Braithwaites. I told you about the Braithwaites.
Pretty sure you did.
Old Cotton family had a fortune at one point until, well, a few changes in the labor laws. Now they're dealing in moonshine. We found their stills hidden all over Lemoyne. Quick as we destroy one, another one pops up. You could call it a pitiful fall from grace, if they had any grace to start with.
I have no time for tax dodging.
Not to mention the fact that Catherine Braithwaite has a rather expensive interest in thoroughbred horses to maintain.
But I heard something about it being gold these families were fighting over.
Well, that's the rumor. But the Grays and the Braithwaites think the other stole a fortune from them. But it happened so long ago, I don't know for sure if it's true.
Must be tough being rich, huh?
So I imagine.
That bad rather suits you, Mr. W.
Yes. I thought so, too.
Whoa!
Hold up. You see that wagon? Dear me, that don't look good. This must have happened recently.
You could try watching once in a while.
Hey, come have a look at this. Deputy, get over here, please. Look, suit and tie. One bullet clean through the forehead. Well, my money says this is the handiwork of a gang called the Lemoyne Raiders.
Yeah, I've run into them.
Let's see if we've got any identification. Okay. We should get going. I'll send someone over here later to clean this up.
Dangerous business, the life of a lawman, isn't it?
Appears so.
I'm just glad we got Archibald here to show us the ropes.
Let's go. There's nothing more we can do here. Would you mind taking the reins? I want to have a look at these papers.
Sure.
I'll direct you. Okay. Frederick Mitchell, Lemoyne State Legislator. Poor fella.
Hey, slow it down a bit.
Go right at the crossroads.
Yep. That's the nicest feathers in my experience.
Oh, and I know the Braithwaites are in business with them. No shame. Trash begets trash, my Uncle Reginald used to say. bear right again here. He had a few stories, let me tell you. Town preacher and town sheriff. He'd drink a sailor under the table before breakfast. He had one tiny hand, like a child's, on the end of a grown man's arm. But anyway, this tells you what kind of people the Braithwaites are. Selling moonshine to murderers. I tell folks don't even speak to him. Don't even look him in the eye.
I'm sure I wouldn't. So, what were you talking about?
Here we are. So what was I saying?
Something about the Braithwaites, I think.
Even saying that word makes me sick. Now, anyone we find here, we bring in alive, understood? Round them up and take this operation down for good. Come on. Let's see what we're dealing with.
Tell you boys, what did I say? I said this place was crawling with vermin, and we just found ourselves the rat's nest par excellence, as they say in Paris. My aunt, she went to Paris back in 78.
Oh, handle this.
Well, the way I see
actually, from my friend here beside, he doesn't have your fine words, but he's definitely the man for the job.
Let's split up. Marty Greenville, me and Archibald. You boys want right or left?
We'll take this way.
Let's stop these filthy, degenerate tax dodgers.
Remember what he said. We need them alive. Let's just knock them out and tie them up.
Got it. Deputy Williams.
How do we get up? Oh, over here, probably.
Gentlemen,
I think that's it.
Well, what do we do now?
We better destroy all this. Any of your boys can handle explosives?
Sure, anyone but him.
Oh, so,
I think you're real funny, Del.
Tell me about the...
That is the last time I'll mention it, I swear.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well,
thank you.
Wait, what? That was Bill. Why was he shooting me? Dang, boy. What are you doing?
Me and my men must return to our lives. Ah, seems like we failed to destroy the last of the moonshine.
Sure.
Would you like us to?
I normally take it for personal consumption. It's sort of part of the job. But I'd better get back home. Why don't I just take a jug or two and leave you boys the rest to show that there's no hard feelings on account of the war?
We are all Americans.
Of course. My cousin, Webster, he used to say some of us is not as American as others, if you know what I mean. Only I didn't quite. Come on, you degenerate, no-good, white trash, hillbilly piece of scum. I know you, Billy Lime.
Finally.
You've always been a
Finally.
Piece of crap. Come on, move.
We have a life. On a land so stupid. A backwater so backwards that even we... are like geniuses.
Bill! Get this stuff out of here!
Come on.
You ride with me.
Okay.
Did you not stash this somewhere near camp, Ross?
Yes. Show it to Hosea. I'm sure he can find a use for it. Bit of trouble back there, Arthur?
Ain't there always? From what they was yelling, I think they were
What are you doing? Old Archibald didn't ask too many questions.
question, so neither should we.
I ain't planning to.
That was worth the effort, though. Deputized and hiding in plain sight. These lawmen. These two families. I mean, I really think we can play this from all sides. It's got Hosea written all over it.
This is starting to sound like the Young Dutch again.
What do you mean, Young Dutch? I'm as strong as I have ever been. Hey, you know what? Why don't I race you back? Okay, you're on. That's the spirit. Okay, on my word. Set, go! You never were much of a rider.
We'll see about that.
So good at running away, Horton.
I never knew age had slowed you down quite so much.
Well, time is a bastard. When you get to be my age, well, you'll know that better than anything. Be well. I had fun with you today. I was gonna say you're like a son to me. But you're more than that.
Even though, at the end of the thing, he ends up killing us. That doesn't sound like right, does it? Let's find the place. Wait, this should be the shame thing, you know. No.
I don't understand that lawman get up.
You be well too.
I'll try. I really will.
Think you can make this place work? your time.
Mr. Morgan, I raised you well.
Oh, don't take too much pride in your work.
Kill Miss Grimshaw, would Dutch be mad?
I think, as a general rule, Dutch likes to avoid murder within the camp. I mean, there was that one time. He was a traitor. Miss Grimshaw, well, Dutch has a soft spot for her.
I thought as much. Was she always like this?
I ain't quite old enough to know.
No, of course. So as long as you've known her?
She's always liked her swill of vinegar.
I'd like to give her a swig of Austin.
Well, just do it discreet.
I will. You fancy a game of dominoes?
Sure, why not?
If I'm playing with you, she'll leave me alone. Can't believe the dominoes survived Blackwater, but my necklace didn't.
Oh, yeah. I thought something looked different.
Well, I stole that one. I'm sure I can sell another easy enough.
I'll keep my eye out for you, too.
Enjoying yourself here.
Well enough, I guess. And you?
Well, it turns out the pursuit of freedom is not a cheap business. Not for us, and not for some of the locals.
Shocking already.
I prefer the corded thing.
You ain't the one handing out the beatings.
No, but I am the one feeding the women and children in the camp. What choice do we have, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know. Well, come on, then. Tell me who.
Here's the list. Refinery worker turned hunter by the name of Vinton Holmes. You'll find him up in the hills north of Strawberry. Ah, an apprentice undertaker. This one, lurking in rows. His name was Gwen Hughes.
And how many of them do you think will be able to pay?
With enough encouragement, both of them.
What are you doing?
Going fishing.
The rivers around here, famous for the smallmouth bass. Fella I met showed me a couple spots. You want to join me?
I can't fish for you. You're far too good.
Oh, come on, come on. Hey, join me. Show you a couple of my tricks. There's a spot not too far from here that I've been wanting to try out.
Glad you're so excited about this.
You will be too when you start pulling out smallmouth. Okay, follow me.
I thought you said it wasn't far.
Too far to walk, though. Yeah, come on. Because the price on my head is so big. This is nothing exactly new to me. And I love to be loyal to Dutch. He sees the world the same as I do. If we have to fight, we fight. If we have to run, we'll run. If we must die, we'll die, but we'll stay free.
And Dutch, you don't feel like, well, that he's doing things a little differently now? You saw what happened with that girl on the ferry.
No fight, good or bad, is won without blood. I know that better than most. I think too many people are focusing on Dutch when they should be looking at themselves, what they could have done better.
Maybe you're right.
We'll cut through to the right here. Try our luck. Pretty country.
Beautiful.
Come on, let's go see what's biting. So we're not in each other's way.
Will you put the gun down?
I don't know business.
You take this spot, Arthur. I'm going to cast from over to the right there, so we're not in each other's way.
Thank you. Okay, I guess we'll end the stream right here. It's been about an hour. See you guys later. Have a nice day and bye.